Okay, so today we start project one, drawing one, which is orthographic drawing plus one cross-section view. Now, I mentioned briefly last time, and you have in the syllabus, that project one will consist of four engineering drawings and two models. Each engineering drawing you have only 1 week to complete. So, I explain today, by next class, you must have it completed or almost completed. So 90%, 80% must be finished. Because next class, I will explain drawing number two, and the class after, drawing number three, and so on. So if you miss this, okay, if you miss first drawing on time, you will miss the next one, and believe me, there is no time. Okay, then in the end, you will be left with an hour, 2 hours to complete two modules, and chaotic, and your mark will be a disaster. Okay, so just make sure, after I explain something, you immediately start the work. Okay, if you do that, there will be no problem this semester for you. Just don't forget. Now, last time I told you to buy certain materials, okay, and one of them is the computer mouse, because we will be working on this in the first project. So each one of you had to choose a design that you like and to have it with you. I advised you not to choose the very tiny small ones. This size is good, or the bigger ones even, okay? So I will use this mouse today to basically go over this drawing, the important things you need to keep in mind, how to start, how to structure the orthographic drawing, and how to do the cross-section view. All of this we will cover today. Now I will use a simplified drawing of this, okay? Simplified. But when you draw on the graph paper, you have to make it 100% exact. So any corner, any curve, anything must be, any detail. You see details here, details here. Everything must be on the drawing. Okay, nothing should be left out. Here I will do a simplified drawing to explain the technique. But as I said, when you draw, it has to be drawn perfect. And you will be drawing in scale 1:1. Scale 1:1. You all should know what scale is by now. When we say 1:1, that means the real size. So this size should be on the paper. Okay? So you need to measure. If you have taken introduction to 3D design in the past with me, you already have been exposed to orthographic drawing. So you know how to measure, you know how to basically draw the views. I will go over it again, of course, here. But it's not the first time you're drawing an orthographic drawing. So you need to measure every piece of this and transfer it to the drawing. And it has to be correct. Before you start measuring details, okay, you need to measure the main things, like the height and what? The length, okay? This is the main thing. And I explained this before, why? Because the length and the height, this will create a box. So that you need to put. So before I draw any detail, I need to know the general box inside which the object fits perfectly, okay? So I need to know the length and the height of it. This is your start. And for my orthographic drawing, I need to select which view will be the front view. I always start with the front view. So now you can choose this to be the front view. You can choose this to be the front view. There is no problem. But this is the first decision, the front view. The front view will influence the other views, okay? And the location, like the location should be placed in a way that you have to take into consideration to have space for all the views. So if I put the front view here, for example, I need to have space for the top view, for the bottom view, for the side view, for the other side view, for maybe section drawing, because there will be a section drawing. Maybe my section drawing will be here, maybe it will be here, maybe it will be up here. So there should be enough space to plan. Before I start drawing, if you see the sheet, this is an example of the A3 sheet. I divided it into middle, okay, and then again I divided it into section. This is any engineering drawing should have this to help me plan the page. Like for example, if you take dotted lines down, okay, from here and dotted lines from here, you know that this is, for example, the middle of the page. Then you have another section here, another section here. You can plan your views where to put what more easy. And you can divide into more even, okay? It's like ruler, ruler on the side. Okay. So. Okay, now this here is your A3 paper. All of you must leave 1 centimeter border, okay? 1 centimeter. This is going to be on the graph paper. Okay, on the graph paper, it has a white edge. I think it is already 1 centimeter. So you just leave it out and you start inside to draw. Let's see. This is an example. So this is an A3 graph paper. So if you notice this white border here, if it's 1 centimeter, you just leave this 1 centimeter out and you start drawing inside, but leave the divisions out. Normally the real engineering drawings are drawn first on this and then transferred on another more clean sheet, but I will not make all this trouble for you. I will leave the drawing on this sheet and just to be correct. I want it to be correct. Okay, this is the main thing. Not to redraw it on another sheet and all this trouble. Okay, so let's start. As I said, we need the height and the length of the object first and to draw the box. So let me see, where can we draw the box here? Of course, it's visual, it's not accurate. So you draw the box first, okay? So if I select this to be the front view from your vision, I draw the box. So I know my mouse fits inside perfectly. So when I start drawing the details, so you don't mess up the views, because the views in orthographic drawing have to be perfectly aligned.
We don't measure it?
Sorry?
The box, we don't measure it?
Yeah, you measure, of course, you measure the length and the height.
And then you make the box.
And then you draw the box, yes. Now, front view. We are going to use third angle rotation. Third angle rotation means that if this is your front view, the top view will be rotated exactly in this way. Okay? Again, front view, top view. Bottom view will be rotated exactly like this. Okay? Again, front view. Now, this side view will be this. So it's rotated from here. Okay? This side view will be this. It will be rotated from here. Now, there is a back view, but we don't need it, because the back view, in this case, it's the same like the front view. So, no new information. If there is new information, we draw the back view. So, we need front view, top view, bottom view, 2 side views, okay? And then a section view. I will explain how to do this. Okay, now, so we need to draw the boxes first before we start any detail. Now this is, as I said, the third angle rotation. The first angle rotation is different, like, not to confuse you, but the rotations are a little different. So if this is the front view, this side view is not this, but this, okay? So it's rotated in this way, a little bit different, but it is not advisable because we like to keep the view close to here. So if I want to check, you know, like you can check your measurements much more easy when it's closer than to have to draw this part here, okay? Mm-hmm. So it's closer. So the third angle rotation, more comfortable to use and more easy. And if you took introduction to 3D design with me, we also used to draw with the same rotation. So it's like a pivot point here And then this is the top view, this is the front view, this is the bottom view. Side, side, okay? That's it. So, the box for the front view is already here. Now, the top view must be perfectly aligned. So, putting lines up. You see it's the same object, just rotate it. So, it's the same length of the box. But the width is maybe different, okay? From here to here, different than from here to here, okay? So, what is it? You measure and you put. Now, top view, front view, bottom view. Now, the bottom view will be exactly like this box, okay? Because from this view and this view, it's the same. Just the information is different, but it's the same measurement box. And please, the space must be the same. So you leave the same space. Now, how much space to leave? There is no rule for this. Important is that all the views have the same space. This space we need to write, like for example, we need to write later front view here, top view, bottom view, this kind of information. So we need enough room for this, okay? And it depends on how much space you have on the paper. If you have a lot of things to draw, then the space becomes smaller. Now, there should be dotted lines on your paper as well. This is just to make sure all the views are aligned perfectly. Now, the side view from here, for example, this view, what is the height, what is the, how much it is from here, it will be the same like from here. So this here you can transfer to here and draw the box. This box, from this view, it will be the same. Just the information, the drawing will be different. So this box, the same like from this view. Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, once you have your boxes ready, and you're sure that the measurements are correct, it is time to start drawing the details. You start with the bigger details, for example, the major curves, and later the details inside the curves, you know, like small lines and other details and small things that you need to measure. So you always start a drawing from the general to the more and more detailed. Okay, now as I said, I will simplify this drawing because we don't have time to draw every single detail. Okay, let's see, let me choose another color. Okay, it needs to fit exactly inside your box because this is the height and this is the length of the object. The length means the total length, like from the last detail, okay, not from here, from the last detail, nothing should get out of the box. Now, then, for example, you will draw the bottom view. So what do you see from the bottom? Yeah, you start measuring and transferring to here. So, for example, Yes. Who are you? Student? Come in, but you're very late. Okay. So, very simplified version. It's not really the accurate. But, as I said, this is just for indication. So, now, the side view, two side views, and a top view, the top view first, okay? So the object from this view. Now, please, for example, this detail, which is this, every detail, it has to fit with the other details. It has to be aligned. So, if you take here, lines up, where is it located here? You know, it's from here to here, located. What is the width of it from here to here? You will measure, okay? Yeah, even the small details need to be measured. And whatever other here details you have, I will not go into all this right now. Now the side views. This view here, okay, and the other view in the other side. now, for example, if you have something like this, again, you will take, you want to know the height from the back, again, you don't have to measure it again, it's already here. So it's located somewhere here. Just the width of it, you need to see, and the shapes, because some mouses have, you know, curves that come out and go this way. And so you need to draw everything the way it is. So be very careful. Not everything is simple. From the front, from this view in here. So here we have again details. For example, this, if there is a corner, for example, where does it stop here? You just take a line and you already know it's somewhere here it needs to stop. And with this detail, somewhere here. This detail here will need to be located somewhere from here to here. So, but you need to know the width of this object, which is not given here. Here you have some things you can also take if it's the same, but you need to be careful because some mouses are smaller from the front and bigger from the back. So obviously then it's not the same, okay? For example, this piece here, if you have such a detail, here it's not very visible, but on the object, you know, for example, that, okay, it starts from here. So how much is from here to here? Maybe, let's say, half centimeter or whatever. So you know from this part how much to go up. Okay, so where is this located? But not from here. You need to locate it here. So another way, you can take it from the top view down. It's located, for example, at this point. It starts. So from this point, take it this way. And you know, for example, it starts from here. Then, the circle, this is the starting point, this is the top, okay, you take it. So it is here located, from this view. And so on. So every detail, you just have views, you take it down or you take it up, and then you find the location. Once you have this view established, it already helps you to take the lines up and down and have the other details to draw. Okay, let me see. So this is the starting, for example, of drawing, orthographic drawing of the maps. Now here, as I said, we will have some writing, front view. View, bottom view. Top view. Side, you can name it side once, side view one, side view two, okay. Now, before we start talking about the section drawing, there is very important things regarding the measurements. So, let me draw this one. Okay. So we need to, you need to put the measurements of every detail here. So, for example, what is the height from here to here? What is the width? What is the height of this detail? What is the size of this? What is everything must be here. So you will have a lot of measurements on the drawing. Please, now where you want to put them? You can put them from this side. You can put measurements from here, from here, from here. So many options, but you must be careful. Don't put measurements where the writing is. So you cannot have, for example, here a measurement saying from here to here it is this much, because you have a writing here. Never put a measurement next to the writing. So if I want to know from here to here, instead of putting it here, I will put it at the top, okay? To stay away from the writing. And if I can't do it here in this view, maybe I can do it in this view, because it's the same. So you choose which view, where to put the measurements. Another thing to be careful, you have like small measurements and big measurements. They must be done in the following order. Small to big, like for example, from here to here how much? From here to here, let's say, for example, 1 centimeter. We don't put centimeter here because we have units later in the box. So 1 from here to here. This is the smallest. Then I want from here to here. For example, 3, for example. Then I want from here to here. For example, 5.1, for example. Okay. Now, look, the smallest starts inside, then the bigger. Don't put, for example, One small here, a big here, a small here, a big here. It's totally wrong. They need to start in this order, okay? And the space from here before the first measurement starts, it should be like 1 centimeter at least, you know. It depends again how much space you have, but don't put it too close to the drawing. It needs to have at least 1 centimeter. And then from each measurement to the other, okay, from each measurement to the other must be the same. So half centimeter, you can leave half centimeter, half centimeter, half centimeter. On all the drawing, the same way, the same technique, the same rule. Not here you leave half centimeter and over there a different, okay? So if I want to put measurements on this view, okay, again, I will first I will look at the smaller details. The small details, put it out. For example, 0.5. Then I want to show from here to here how much it is, the space. For example, 6. Now, then, for example, I want to show how much it is from here to here. So again, in the same order, and with the same, it should be with the same spacing, okay? Here it's not totally accurate. It's a little closer. So the same spacing. If it's 0.5 here, it must be 0.5 here. And you can have a lot of other measurements that you want to show. So, also very important, when you have a line, okay, a measurement line, these triangles, okay, the corner of this triangle should always touch the line. I don't want to see the line here and the corner out of the line. Not allowed, okay? It must be perfectly on the line. All of these triangles must be the same size. This is not freehand, okay? They must be exactly the same size. So if this is here 0.3 millimeter, everywhere it must be like this, okay? And the number should be deleted exactly in the middle of the line and put the number here. So for example, 2. Now, look at this measurement here, what I did. I put 2 lines like this, and then I put the measurement here or on the side. This is when there is no space. Like if it's so small, the detail, there is no space to do it in this way. Then you do it in this way. And this is also correct. Okay, the numbers must be the same size everywhere. Not here a big number, okay, and here a small number. No, everywhere the same size numbers. Perfect, must be. It must be exactly in the middle of the line. That's very important. So everything is exact, okay, in this drawing. All the measurements, everything, the same style, the same way, the same everything. Okay, now, you are not allowed to put measurements inside the object. Like for example, you're not allowed to tell me this detail here, okay, and to put the lines here and to tell me, okay, here is the measurement. Inside the object, never, okay? All the measurements outside must be taken. If you have circular objects like this one, okay? So it has a center. Circular objects are defined by, like if you have a circle, you do this, then it's defined by this kind of line. So it's a little different than the other lines, okay? And you need to say, for example, the diameter or the radius, how much it is. So for example, now here it's a little bit problematic because of the writing. Okay, I will do it anyway because now, okay, we can do it here from the top. Diameter, for example, 3 centimeters, depends on the units, okay? What units you use. So, this is how you could show it. If you have space in this kind of place to put it here or here, it's okay. But usually you have writing, so be careful about that. Try to keep them away from the writing. Okay. When there is a detail, like for example, I want to show this line here. From here to here, how much it is. So this dotted line here, it's not actually a dotted line, it's a straight line. It's preferably a very thin straight line. You need to take it from inside the object, like this, to go out, okay? And from here, it will continue to go out. And then put the measurement. Like I did here also, but it's not very clear. So, this line will go inside the object, okay, which is fine, as long as the thickness is very thin. We don't want to make heavy lines. The heavy lines were only on the object lines. What are the object lines? This here, okay? The main lines of the object, okay? That's around the object. This is object line. This here, very important, like clear details. You see here these separation lines here, they're very clear. They even have distance, 1 millimeter or something. So if you have this kind of stuff, everything, this is heavy. You know, the heaviest, the darkest line. Then you have these lines should be less heavy, but the lightest lines should be the construction lines. So any of these lines that you show how you constructed the object should be the lightest. If you remember from introduction to 3D design, we had similar technique. I told you some lines you need to make it heavy to make the object stand out, and all these construction lines that you use to draw the object should be lightest. And if you have measurement lines, make them in between. Now, in engineering drawing, it goes really much more complicated than that. You have really every type of line. You have a lot of type of lines and a lot of thicknesses. We will not go into this detail. This is enough, okay, if you apply it for now and accurately. Later, when you start drawing on AutoCAD and these kind of programs, it will already show you these extra details. So we don't want to go into all of these details right now. As long as you remember 3 types of lines, keep 3 thicknesses, and you manage to do all these other details correct, it should be a decent drawing. Now, another detail to keep in mind, which is not very clear in the drawing, because it's a hand drawing, when you try to show a measurement, for example, I want to show from here to here. Where is the object line? And where I start the measurement, you need to leave 3 millimeters. Let's say 2 or 3 millimeters distance. Do not connect it with the object. Like, do not start, for example, connect here and start drawing like this. No, there needs to be a space, okay? This space from here to here, 2 or 3 millimeters you can leave. And then start the line. This is important for not to confuse the eyes.
The measurement line,
yes. Like for example, you want to show from here to here the height. So you have to have a line, okay?
Yeah.
standing, but this line, where does it start? 3 millimeters away from the object. And this line here, where does it start? Okay, 3 millimeters or 2 away from the object. And then it must be 1 centimeter away from the object, okay? And then you draw the line. The triangles, the same. In exactly in the middle, you tell me what is the height. We already actually have it, okay, here. So please do not repeat measurements. Like for example, we already put here the height. No need to put the height again. But this is just to explain to you what you need to be careful about. So the distance between the object, I need to see a small distance left, not connect the lines. Because when you have a lot of lines, a lot of measurements, a lot of detail, and all of them are with the same color, okay? It starts playing around. So sometimes you can confuse object line with measurement line with some detail. So that's why they have these rules to follow. Okay. Now, so these are some important things. Okay, now, what else? The writing, these writings here, you don't need to do them freehand, not freehand. They will be, you can print them on stickers, on white stickers, okay? And put them under each view, but they have to be perfectly put, I mean aligned, okay? Not one here, the other there, one on no. All of them must be underneath, exactly. So if I put lines down, it should be aligned with this. The distance between the writing and the object, the same. Everything the same, you know? What you do in one place, you do the same in another place. Also here, you will have a box in this place. So here you will have a box with information. What information you need to put? It is in your syllabus. Where is the, which day of the week we are? This here, we are taking today, drawing one, project one. Here is what you need to do, exactly like this box. So, you know, the box outline must be heavy. The inside will be divided into exactly how I wrote it. So here, design 212, engineering, drawing, and model making. Then underneath here, project 1, phase A. Then project name, student name, type of drawing, sheet number, scale, units. Some of the information I already put you here. Exactly what you need to have. And when you write something inside this, now there will be, you will have it done on a computer and print it on a simple Word program. You can just write, make a small box, and it's not complicated. If you want to draw by hand, okay, no problem. You can make everything by hand to write. But to make it more easy for you, I allow you to print on sticker and put. But still, the writing must be exactly in the middle. So for example, if we have here some writing, it must be in the middle, not touch the border. Not touch the border. Or touch. Start from here, for example, if this is a student name, for example, my name, to start here. No. Okay? This is very bad. Nothing should touch borders in design. Okay? So it must be perfectly located in the middle. Okay? Which will be easy if you do it on a computer. But I've seen even students doing it on computer and it's wrong. So, be careful. The information must be exactly. The boxes will stay the same on all drawings, the same size, the same everything. Just the sheet number will be different and the drawing type. And I put you it here. It can't be more easy than this. You just look and you put in the correct place. Now, Okay, now, what else do we need to know here? Now, as I said here, the numbers, we don't write centimeter or millimeter because we will have here somewhere says units, okay? And we use units centimeter, okay? Scale is 1 to 1, we already explained this. What else here important? Let me see. So this will be the first drawing number one. And okay, that will be it, I guess, for the box. Just make sure you don't put the wrong box in the, you know, for the wrong drawing. Just make sure it's the correct one. And keep all of them the same size. So you can print them in one time after, at the end, when we finish them. You don't need to go in each drawing, print, 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 no. You finish all the drawings, what's in here, and then you print the stuff and you glue it. That's if you want to print. If you want to write, you write, okay? And that needs to be very clean. So, now I believe we can start the section drawing. How to do a section drawing? Yes?
The measurements of the maps itself. Does the box has to be exactly as the measurements?
Yes, of course.
So it can touch like the boxes outside and stuff. So
No. Because then it's wrong.
So the box can't be bigger than the mouse or smaller. It just has to fit perfectly.
It has to fit perfectly. That's why I'm telling you, you have to measure the height and the length. Maximum length, maximum height. On the maximum point. You see, because you have different heights on different points. The maximum. The one that is mostly the surface up. And here the same. Otherwise, if you have it bigger or smaller, what's the point of this box? This is to exactly organize your views. So I know this is the height of the maximum height of my mouse, so I can take, and so I don't make mistakes with the view. One view to be up, one or down, okay? That's why I'm drawing these first, then the details inside, to make the drawing perfect. If you start with details, the views might shift. So I don't advise to do this. Okay. Now, the size of the font, what to choose for this one, please, you know, choose something sensible. There is no rule exactly for it, but considering it's an A3 size drawing, it's not very big. So don't choose writing to stand out more than the drawing. So for example, between around 12 points is perfect, you know, not bigger. We don't want the writing to stand out, we want these objects, the drawing to stand out. And again, with the numbers here, don't make it too big, okay? Keep them in a visually sensible way for the size of the drawing, I mean. If you're not sure about something, before you print, you can show me, or when you start drawing on this, I will see it anyway. So now the section view. How do we draw, what is first of all a section view? This is to show on what's inside the object, but it's like cutting the object. So for example, I might decide to cut it in this way, okay? Like this. I might decide to cut it from here, or like this, okay? So, every time you change the place where you cut, okay, the details inside will be different. Mm-hmm. And in some drawings, you will see a lot of, more than one section view. It's like maybe one section view like this, one section view from here. It's to show some details inside. Now, what is asked of you is one section view. But for as example, I will draw several so you get the hang of the technique. Like what if we cut like this, what if we cut like this, and so on, just to understand it. So let us start and we will see. Now, where shall we cut first? Now, let me choose the front view, and let me cut, for example, starting from the maximum point, and cut in this way. Now, the section cut is shown. Oops. So the line for the section is different than these lines. So it's not like this. Not like this, okay? It is like this. Very important, okay? Otherwise you will confuse it with a measurement line. And it says exactly where it's cutting through the object, okay? And in what direction? Like, if the arrows show that way, that means I want to cut the object like this and see what's inside here. So this part, eliminate it, as if it doesn't exist, okay? However, if I put the arrows to show this direction, what does it mean? That this part is eliminated and I want to see what's inside here. So I rotate this part and show what's inside here. So this is the importance of how you put the arrows, which way they show. This way or that way. This way or that way. It's important, okay? Okay. Now, this will be our first cut. And you have to name it. This is the first cut. It's going to be A. This is how you name it, not with numbers, with letters, AA. Now, the section, so the arrows go this way, that means I'm eliminating this part, and this part must be rotated like this, and to see what's inside here. That means it has to be placed from this side. It is like this view, you see, like this view, but now it's opened, okay? It's opened exactly in this point. Now, because this is the upper point, like this one, this section view will have the same height. So it will be the same, it will have the same cross section, the same measurement like this, but it will be now opened. For example, just draw it quickly. Now, how do we show that it's open? When you imagine cutting through any object, the walls will have a thickness, okay? Will have a thickness to it. This is material, this is plastic, okay? So, if you open it, and you see, you will see a thickness to the wall. Maybe so small, maybe a half millimeter or 1 millimeter, okay? But it has a thickness. So, you will need to draw the thickness of the wall. I will make it bigger so you can see, you know. But on your drawing, it must be, you know, accurate. Now, anything cut, we have to show with lines, okay, like this, 45 degree lines. So these lines are at 45 degrees, go around the, this is the thickness of the material. Now, this is open. Show me what's inside. Now, obviously you will not go and cut this object for real, but you need to just, in general, look inside. What's inside here? Okay, if I'm cutting through this point, what will I see? Obviously, you will see part of this here object, you will see of this board, so you need to draw this details, everything what you see inside here, okay? So you see the mechanics inside, you draw them. Whatever is inside here. general, okay, whatever here, details it has, you draw. Now, okay, what if we cut, not here, but what if we cut here at the end? You see here where it becomes, when it starts going down, you can see here. What if I cut here?
We won't see the wall, right?
What?
I'm not gonna see the wall on the mouse because the top of it will be covering it. Right?
When you will not see the wall?
If I took it from the back like this.
Like this, you. Well, it depends. I think you will see the ball.
Not all of it,
yes.
Yeah.
Now look, because now, where is the point of start of the cut? Here and here. Where is it located? You take a line and... Oops. And to the end, okay. So, now, you know, if we have to draw another view here, you will still have this part visible.
Yeah, like this. Yeah.
You see, this part will still be visible. But now, because the cut starts from this point, okay, from this point, so some parts will not be as clear as in the first view. And again, you have to draw whatever else is visible inside. Depends on where you cut, some things will be hidden, some things will be shown. Now, here, you need to write always, like, for example, is this section AA or section BB, you know? So, here you write AA, here you write AA. If it's BB, then you have to write here B-B. Very important, okay? Because you might have several section views, they have to be named and written in this way. Okay, let's say, what if we cut another way? What can we cut now? What if we cut this view from this view, and I cut in the middle? What will happen then? So shall we try? Okay, so let's say we cut here in the middle, and we have these lines going this way again. And this will be C. C. So. This view of the mouse, cut in the middle, okay? Now, after we cut it in the middle, it will be rotated, because we need to see, okay, look the arrows, okay? It points that way. That means we want to see what's inside here. So this part is eliminated. So, to see what's inside here, we need to have rotated like this, okay? If the lines were the other way, we need to rotate it that way. Now, because I don't have space here, you know, I can draw outside to show you, but let me also for explanation to change the arrows the other way so we can draw it here instead. So in this case, it means that we want to see what's inside this part here, okay? And this part now will be eliminated. So to show what's inside here, we cannot rotate it like this. We have to rotate it like this, okay? And draw it. So it will look similar to this view, but to rotate it on the other side. So something like that. So it will have a box like this here.
Would it fit?
It won't fit in the board, but on your paper it has to fit. Okay? So if you see, for example, it doesn't fit, see if it fits somewhere else, or change the whole drawing to make it fit. So you can draw, for example, in the beginning a sketch with the boxes, you know?
Yeah.
Now, when you draw the boxes, you can already decide where you want to cut. So if I draw this box and I decide, okay, later I want to cut my object like this and like this, so you can leave more space from here or from here or from the top. So you can plan this out. Once you draw the boxes and you see the object, okay, later I want to cut it from this way, and you leave more space from the sides. So plan it out that way. But in this case, we are just explaining, so no need to be all this accurate. So for example, okay, there won't be space here. Never let any object touch the border, okay? So what happened here, be careful, okay? There has to be always space around, white space. So this is not good here. Okay, and then you will start drawing this object in here, but opened. So very quickly. And it will have what, the wall thickness, okay? Again, 45 degrees lines. This is not freehand with the ruler, okay? T-square and ruler. This is 45 degree. You have to go and draw it perfect. Everything needs to be perfect in this drawing. And then you name this view, section view C-C. And you show, of course, what is inside here. So, what can you see here inside? Okay, from here you will see, for example, this the circle, and from in here you will also see the circle, and maybe you can see even other details, and the dashboard inside, and other here details. Whatever happens, you draw. Whatever you can see when you open this. Sometimes you have these also, the long parts. Of the mouse, you know, like this structure inside. You know, these. These are for to make it fit. Like when I press on it, it clicks, you know, like it clicks to place. So these are for this reason. Placed. And sometimes, because of the manufacturing, how they manufacture this plastic, it's a liquid and it goes inside a piece that looks like this with an opening. So they come from these inside, you know, and these stay in place. So sometimes they have a functional reason to be here. Sometimes it's because of how it's manufactured. You see these items here? Sometimes they have functional reason. Sometimes it is because of the manufacturing way of plastic. So, but you need to draw. For example, what is this piece here? Now, no need for you to understand, but you need to draw it, okay? If we see it, draw it. In the cut. Okay. So. Don't touch the border. Okay, just so you don't make the mistake. There should be very comfortable space left. The only thing that touches the border is this box, okay? It should be inside the border, and it will touch the border. That's the only thing. Otherwise, nothing. Okay. Now, sometimes you will have cuts from other views, so sometimes you have rotations that go, for example, here or here. It depends, okay? So that's also an option. Actually, this view, you see here this object? So if we cut it in the middle, okay, and the arrows show down, Okay, then we need to see what's inside here. So we will need to rotate it like this, but open, and here. So it's similar like this, but here. So you can also plan the space out, so which view to cut, so that the rotation happens where you have space.
Okay? How many sections do we need?
One section. If you want to put more, that's great. Okay, that's...
So we only have to choose one of these.
Not one of these, one of your choice.
Yeah, I mean like this.
Yes, yes, it's like this. So if you have one section, it will be AA, and that's it. If you want to be even more, you know, like to do like extra work, you can have two section views, okay? So the more you do, the more detailed you are, the more you try to put extra effort, the better for you and the marks. Now, there is this sheet here that is for this drawing. So inside you will find here an example of an engineering drawing similar to what we are doing. Front view, top view, bottom view, side view, a section, look, section AA, a cut through here as example, okay? And because the lines show this way, the object is rotated that way. So, and the way it's ordered, if you notice the space in between the views is the same. The things that we discussed, nothing different. Here, even the arrows, you know, a lot of similar things, but in a more clean way. Here, orthographic drawing. What are the views? For example, you have a simple object and the rotations. In case you have a problem of understanding this, you can review it. Here, examples of first angle projection and third angle. We are using the third angle projection, and stick to that, please. This is another orthographic drawing. Front view, top view, bottom view, side views, and a back view in this case. Let me see what else here. This is still continuation of the orthographic explanations.
Is this on the internet?
Yes, yes, this is on e-learning from yesterday. This is for the first drawing. And then you have here about sectioning. You know, some explanations with some visuals, you know. And here, what I told you about, the thickness of the material and the cross-sectioning inside, like the 45-degree angle, where you show the thickness of the material. Where there is space, there is no lines, okay? So you can see an example, how it's cut and how it's shown here in 3D. So it's, you know, it's better for you to understand. What do we have else here? So, scaling versus dimensioning. This thing very important, just to remind you. Now, the scale of the drawing, this is 1:1. So it's the same size like the object. So the measurements here, all the measurements are the real measurements. Now what if the scale is different? What if you had to do it 1:2, for example, or 1:10, or one, the scale is different. So for example, this is not the real size, but for example, smaller. Then what about the measurements? What numbers should you put? What did you learn from before? The same numbers. So no matter what the scale, you put always the real number. So what is it in real life? If this is in real life, 5 centimeter, you put it 5 centimeter, even if this is so small or so big, as a scale, okay? Just remember this, because it's easy to mix up. So here it's explained to you again, okay? So whatever the size, this pen is the same like this one, but smaller, like different scale. But the size, look, the measurement is the same. You show the real measurement of the object, always. Here, arrangement of dimensions, things that I explained, how to arrange it, like what is allowed to do and what is not allowed to be done. This is correct, for example, and this is incorrect, to put it inside. Like we explained. Here, again, the spacing, you know, the things that I also talked about. And the order of dimensions, the same things that I talked about, but here in a more clean way, okay, so you can maybe understand better, and so on. Now this is really the minimum of the minimum for engineering drawing. The realities, they get more complicated. As I said, the line types, the thicknesses, it can go on and on and on. Because engineering drawings show a lot of detail. A lot of detail sometimes. This is very simple object, but imagine a more complicated object, and you have all these lines, and if you don't differentiate the thicknesses and the types, it's very easy to confuse the viewer. It becomes too much numbers, too much lines, too much detail, and all of them the same color. So the only choice you have is to play with the thickness of the line and the type of the line. So is it a straight line? Is it a dotted line? Is it this kind of line? And the thicknesses and many other types, okay? I don't want you at this stage to go into this much detail. If you apply what we discussed here and what's on the sheets, it's already good enough, okay, for this level. Okay, so this is basically it in general. Do you have any questions to ask me? Yes.
When you cut inside the mouse, you don't want the small measurements, or do you do every like small details measurement?
You mean to put it like to tell me the measurement,
yeah,
of it? No need for that. Only if you have a big piece, like for example this. For example, circular piece, it's a major piece. You can put its measurement, but you know, it depends. If you already put it here, we already put it here, that the diameter is, you will not repeat it. Don't repeat information. Try to show as much details as you can and measurements without repeating detail. That's important. And there is also this here inside. You know, with very, very small details inside. Now, this in general, draw it. Take the major, you know, like the most important shapes, and the other things that are super small, or these kind of things, no need to draw. Okay? No need to draw, because this is not a stable object. I can look at it this way, or, you know, but this is plastic and it's stable, so I draw all the things that are stable, not these. That can fold, and you know, so this is important. So there's no need to draw it, but but you need to draw the details. Like for example, the opening, these openings, this here, details, everything. Be careful if you have curvatures on the object. Maybe that's not very clear. Let me see. Again, to go back to the cubes, okay, in the past. Now, this is what, from the drawing, what do you understand? These are corners, okay? Straight line, one line means corner. What if it's not a corner? What if we have a radius? The radius, okay? So let's say it starts from here and it ends from here. There is always, for radiuses, a start and an end. So this is a straight line, then the radius starts, then it ends, then it becomes straight line again. Okay, and from here we have the same, from the other side. Then we don't have one line anymore. We have two lines. Okay? The same can happen inside this object. Okay? Inside this object. So sometimes you have corners, sometimes this is a very cornered object, but there is small curves here at the side. It depends on the design of the mouse. Sometimes you find very curvy and, you know, like a lot of curves. So be careful. If you have a curve, it needs to have two lines. Now, how big is the radius? That depends. Sometimes you have radiuses that, for example, are big from here. Sorry, let me repeat this here. So, some radiuses could be big, for example, from one side and become very small from the other side. In this case, because these are complicated objects, so maybe a radius starts small and become big and small, okay? So, also your lines, you have to show this detail in these drawings. What if you have this kind of object? Okay, let's say again the cube. What if we have radius here and radius here? So it's like two different lines with radiuses. It depends on how big the radius is, start point, end point. For example, start point, end point. Okay, let's say this is the radius. But we have also a radius here. So we have also a radius from this side. So what will happen here in this case? Then the object will look will become like this, okay? And if we have on all the four sides, it will continue round it up. So two lines with two radiuses coming together, it might happen in some of the objects. Any small detail, we need to see it here, highly detailed, okay? With all the details, what happens here, okay? From all the views, we need to see this. So, even when there is a distance, you see here when I draw this object here, in reality it's not that simple. There is, if I draw it bigger, you know, there is a hole which is not, it's not straight. It has radius on the side. This is how it looks. And then the circle is inside here. So this is here space around, this is a space maybe half millimeter around where the circle is put inside, because it's a piece, you know, like you can remove it and place it back. So there is a space around it. This needs to be drawn. So if you don't draw this and you just draw me this here object, it's wrong on the real drawing, I mean, okay? You will be drawing with pencil and on the graph paper is divided in millimeters. If some objects have half millimeter, you will draw it correct. And everything must be shown in detail, okay? The more detailed you are, the better your mark. The more inaccurate, okay, the worse it will become. So look at every single detail, how it's done, and draw it correct. As I said, you will be drawing with pencil. Just keep in mind the object lines to be a little bit heavier, a little bit stronger, so they stand out. And then the these kind of lines that show sections, measurements, to be the second. Then these, the construction lines, like these lines that show me the views, the alignments, this should be the lightest, but they should be on the drawing, everything, okay? And don't forget to divide the paper and to organize everything in a good way. So, okay, I think this clarifies the first drawing. Now it's time for you to go home and start it, okay? Any questions? Anything final, not clear?
When do we give you this?
Now, you will not give me this now, but you need to complete it in by next class.
Okay.
Now, by next class, if it's not 100% finished, but 90% finished, it's okay. But next class, we start the second drawing. I don't want the first drawing. I want it at the end of the project. So, after you finish four drawings, two models, I will tell you, there is here actually inside the syllabus, when you need to submit the drawings, when you need to submit the models. Everything have its day, okay? Okay, and it says inside exactly when, and it's not far away. So in the beginning, you only collect drawings. If you have a question, you ask me.
You
show
me.
Well, I can, in general, of course, if you have a question, I can show, I can, you know, if you have a problem, I will not help you, like with the drawing.
Yes,
if you have a question, I will answer, but you need to consider, it depends on the class size. Like, this number of students, you know, perfect to help, but I have like 31 students, then obviously there is no time to help everyone. So if the class is too big, less help is available. So if you have a question to ask, it's very fast. I cannot, you know, take time with you too much and explain and fix mistakes. We don't have time for this because the class, as you can see, is already taken by the explanation. So you need to focus. As long as you apply the rules, you know, you are going in the right direction. If there is a problem, like with a question, a quick question, I can answer. What time is it?
Okay.
4:30. Okay, so we have to finish the class now. Let me stop the recording. It's enough.